Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, the moment has arrived. Malam Buhari's agents have pressed the charges against Omoyele Sowore. The charges of course reads like a comedy hour. Guys, I bring you this. Sowore slammed with treason, money laundering and cyber stalking Buhari. That's the headline. Sowore slammed with treason, money laundering and cyber stalking Buhari. So let's get into exactly what this means. The federal government has slammed a fresh 7-count charge against detained political activist and convener of the Revolution Now protest, Mr. Omoyele Sowore, accusing him of treason, money laundering and cyber stalking President Muhammadu Buhari. The case was filed at the Abuja Division of the Federal High Court and it comes 24 hours to the expiration of the 45-day period the court permitted the DSS to hold him. Also charged with Sowore in case number FHC/ABJ/CR/235/2019 is Olawale Adebayo Bakare, also known as Mandate, who was arrested in Oshogbo, Osun State. According to the charge, the federal government alleges that the defendants conspired to commit treasonable felony contrary to Section 516 of the Criminal Code Act Cap C-38 laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004 and punishable under the same section of the act. That you, Omoyele Stephen Sowore, male adult of number 1 Mosafejo Street, Kiribo, Ese Odo Local Government, Ondo State, Olawale Adebayo Bakare, aka Mandate, male adult of Olaiya Aka, Oshogbo Local Government, Osun State, and others at large under the aegis of Coalition for Revolution, CORE, sometimes in August 2019, in Abuja, Lagos, and other parts of Nigeria within the jurisdiction of this honorable court, did conspire amongst yourself to stage a revolution campaign on the 5th day of August 2019, tagged Revolution Now, aimed at removing the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria during his term of office, otherwise known than by constitutional means. The government also accuses Sowore of committing cyber stalking contrary to sections 24(1)(b) of the Cyber Crimes Prohibition Prevention Act 2015 and punishable under the same section of the act. Cyber stalking means the repeated use of electronic communications to harass and frighten someone, for example, by sending threatening emails. Another count accuses him of illegally transferring funds contrary to Section 15(1) of the Money Laundering Prohibition Act 2011 and punishable under the same section of the Act. The government alleges that Sowore on April 2 at Lagos and Abuja transferred by means of Swift Wire the sum of $19,975 from his United Bank of Africa PLC account number, he goes on to quote the account number, credited by Citibank, New York City, USA, into Sahara Reporters Media Foundation, GTB account, then he gives the account number, with the aim of concealing or disguising the illicit origin of the funds. It alleged that he also transferred $16,975 from the same UBA account, credited to him by Landrum, LANDRUM of 7E146, and then goes on to give an American address anyway, which is not really relevant to this particular thing, via Citibank, the aim to conceal the illicit origin of the funds. The charge, which was endorsed by the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami SAN, was signed by a senior state counsel, Mr. A.M. Alilu. So Malami and Alilu are the people that they are using now to prosecute him. So let's carry on. The federal government has already lined up 6 witnesses against the defendants, including bank officials from UBA and GTB. The detained activist and publisher of Sahara Reporters was the presidential candidate of the African Action Congress AAC in the last general election. He has been in the custody of the Department of State Services DSS since August 2nd when he was arrested. The court had granted DSS leave to detain him for 45 days to enable the agency conclude its investigations. The court gave the agency the leave to apply for extension of the detention order after September 21st. DSS had told the court that Sowore got foreign sponsorship to wage war against the administration of President Muhammadu Buhari. It tendered evidence to prove that Sowore held meetings with both the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Nnamdi Kanu, and members of the proscribed Islamic Movement of Nigeria, IMN. So now these are the charges now that have been leveled against Omoyele Sowore. So now let's go through them one by one, because as I said, it's comedy hour, but then of course within the Nigerian space, this comedy very quickly often turns into a tragedy. So let's see exactly what's being said here. So first, the first charge, of course, and the most concerning charge, is the treasonable felony. Treasonable felony is a capital offense. So treasonable felony is a capital offense, and the consequences of that can be very dire. So for them now to prove that treasonable felony has taken place is something I'm hoping that the courts in Nigeria will task them very hard on. But then, of course, from the antecedents that we've been seeing for the last 4 years, especially what we saw play out in the last presidential panel, the Presidential Election Tribunal, we know, of course, that the laws in Nigeria is not decided on the basis of the constitution, but the political wills of the people in charge of the nation at the moment. So this is really where the concern is for this fella, especially with regards to this treasonable felony being leveled against him, because treasonable felony is probably one of the highest, if not the highest, crime that you can level against somebody outside of accusing somebody of taking a life. So that is one of the most egregious sort of crime that you can level against somebody. So it's a real concern, that one. Now the second one is the money laundering. So now this one is quite laughable, and this is where the comedy comes in. So here we have the CEO of a multinational media platform moving monies from the accounts of the media platform in between accounts, and you can see the audit trail. So the accounts where the money is being moved from are his business account, and the accounts that the money is being moved to is his personal account. And the money is being moved, how much is this money laundering exactly? We are talking $16,000. $16,000 is a bit of money, but $16,000 is not what people describe as money laundering. We're not talking about the millions of dollars that is being purloined from central bank. We're talking about a guy moving monies from his own business account into his own personal account, and you are saying is of illicit origin. So what is illicit or illicit about that, however you are choosing to pronounce it, is really the question, because we can see the audit trail and it's quite routine and routinous. Somebody moving money from a business account, which is a business that he owns, and the whole world knows that he owns that business. There's nobody on this planet that does not know that Omoyele Sowore owns Sahara Reporters. So he's moving money from a Sahara Reporter account into his own personal account, or whichever account, certainly an account reflecting in his name. So what is the illicit transaction then that took place in that routine transaction is really where the question is. So this is where the comedy comes in, because they've not really described the illicit origin that they are hinting at, because it is not for him to prove his innocence, it is for them to prove his guilt. So if they are describing that movement of money as illicit, then they surely then have to show that that money was being moved illegally, or the origins of that money is questionable. And if it is questionable, then you have to then present evidence of the questions that is being asked of that money. So this is just very basic stuff. So that is quite laughable. But the funniest one of them all, of course, is the cyber stalking of Buhari. So now this is now where we have to just kick our legs up and start to laugh. Cyber stalking Buhari. So for this guy to be critical of the Buhari regime is cyber stalking Buhari. And by the way, how can you cyber stalk somebody that is not even able to use a computer? Because there's no awareness that Buhari is able to use a computer, and it's the widely perceived wisdom within the Nigerian space that this guy is not really somebody that is able to use a computer. I'll be very surprised if Buhari has ever switched on a computer before. Of course, he would know how to switch it on, because he will see the on button and he knows enough to know if you press the on button, then the computer will come on. But I'll be hard pushed to imagine this guy actually sitting at a computer and using it. I cannot imagine that. So how can you cyber bully somebody that doesn't even know how to use a computer is really the question. And then of course, what is the cyber bullying element of this is the next question, really, because how do you cyber bully a president? If you are critical of the regime, is that cyber bullying? If you are holding the regime to account, is that cyber bullying? So how exactly is this cyber bullying or cyber stalking, let's put it in the right terms, because this of course is something that's been filed in court. So how is he cyber stalking Buhari is really the question, because this is just beyond ridiculous. So the ridiculousness of the state of play within the Nigerian space is obviously the topic of this particular video, and this is what I am inviting you to come have a chat with me about. But before you come have that chat with me, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come tell me what you are understanding by this cyber stalking in the comment section. So I'll leave you here, join you there, but here I say peace.